台湾在蔡英文总统带领之下，在两岸的政策上面，其实都相当的稳健，也受到国际社会的肯定跟支持。我们并没有进行任何的挑衅，那台湾只是想要维持民主自由的生活体制，只要对等尊严，台湾很乐意跟中国彼此交流合作，促进两岸人民的福祉，来创造和平共荣。过去八年来，蔡英文总统在外交国防两岸的稳健领导是深受国际社会的肯定，未来我也将依据中华民国宪政体制推动两岸的事务，希望未来两岸都能够回到健康有序的交流。当然也一如你所说，蔡英文总统这八年来持续不断的释出善意，但很可惜中国并没有给予应有的回应了。那我们也希望在未来新的情势之下，中国也能够体认到和平是符合双方的利益，台海的稳定更是世界安全跟繁荣的必要元素啊。那中国也能够体认到他也有责任，大家共同来促进两岸的稳定跟发展。
这是胜选之后的第一场记者会，稍后我们要邀请提问的媒体能够先举手，之后表达自己所属的代表媒体，再说名字，紧接着再进行提问。首先第一题。
Before we begin the first question, I would just like to make a quick clarification on a mistranslation that was made. 中华民国的宪政体制 means the ROC constitutional framework. This was mistranslated during the English part of the translation. Now let us begin with the first question. So if you could again, please state your name as well as the media outlet that you represent.Let's try in the back there. Stephen from Reuters. Stephen from Bloomberg. Sorry about that.
Hello and congratulations on the election victory. I'm Stephen Engel, a television correspondent for Bloomberg Television, out of Hong Kong. Obviously, with some 7 million votes cast for the two opposition candidates, there is room in the island for a softer voice towards China. I'd like to get your priorities to mitigate the risks to your most critical industry, semiconductors and high-tech, advanced tech, which have felt the pressure of increased tension between China and the U.S. and China and Taiwan. You told Bloomberg in Augustthat Taiwan companies building factories overseas, whether it's in Arizona, Kumamoto, Japan, was a positive thing because it displayed Taiwan's economic power. But how do you help mitigate the risk that increasing tension with China essentially could weaken that strategic advantage, that strategic importance that the chip industryprovides Taiwan. Thank you very much.
我是来自彭博社的 Stephen Engel， 负责彭博香港的电视新闻。首先恭喜两位当选人，不过我们看到有700多万票是投给反对党的另外四位候选人，那么这充分的说明台湾岛内应该还有一定的空间可以让我们对于中国采取相对比较温和的一个态度。我想请教的事情是，请问你们当选之后要如何减缓对于台湾来说非常重要的产业，例如半导体还有高科技先进产业的风险？毕竟这一些先进高科技产业，他们在中美的战争之间，中美贸易战之间，或者是中国和台湾的冲突之间， 可以说是遭受到更多的风险。因为您在八月接受彭博社专访的时候有提到，台湾的企业到海外布局，例如说到美国亚利桑那州，到日本的熊本去设厂，其实都是正面的展现了台湾企业的实力。但是我们想要了解的事情是，您要如何减缓这些冲突所带来的风险，以免对于台湾来说，在战略上如此重要的产业可能会遭受到更高的风险。谢谢。
好，谢谢您宝贵的问题。在全球智慧化的时代，半导体产业是非常关键的产业。台湾的半导体产业固然是台湾的优势，也是对世界的责任。那当然也是因为台湾的半导体产业也是世界共同的资产，因为半导体产业是一个全球分工才有办法成就的一项产业，所以不仅仅台湾会珍惜，那我们也希望中国跟国际社会都能够一起来珍惜这个产业。
First of all, thank you for your question. There are many industries around the world that are now moving toward a more intelligent or smarter industry, and one of them is semiconductors. Semiconductor industry, of course, is critical throughout the world. Of course, Taiwan enjoys certain advantages in the semiconductor industry, but also the world, it is also Taiwan's responsibility to ensure that the world would also enjoy this advantage.Of course, we know that Taiwan's semiconductor industry has an advantage, but we also know that the semiconductor industry is also the world's common asset. And the advancement of the semiconductor industry is actually the result of division of labor around the world. So not only Taiwan needs to cherish this achievement, China and other countries must also cherish this industry.
台湾在蔡英文总统带领之下，在两岸的政策上面其实都相当的稳健，也受到国际社会的肯定跟支持。
Under the leadership of President Tsai Ing-wen, cross-strait policy has been steady, and this method has actually gained the recognition of the international community.
我们并没有进行任何的挑衅，那台湾只是想要维持民主自由的生活体制。
Taiwan did not engage in any provocative actions. We only want to maintain a free and democratic style of living.
我刚刚在致辞当中也表达了同样的立场。
I also expressed the same stance in my address earlier.
只要对等尊严，台湾很乐意跟中国彼此交流合作，促进两岸人民的福祉，来创造和平共荣。
As long as there's dignity and parity between two sides of the strait, Taiwan is very willing to engage in dialogues with China. We're willing to exchange, to cooperate, for the benefit of the people on both sides of the strait so that we can create a peaceful and also prosperous environment.
而对于半导体产业的发展，未来我会大力的来协助半导体产业从材料、设备、研发、IC 设计、制造、封装测试，形成一个更完整的产业链，能够让半导体产业在台湾更进一步的发展，也能够因此造福全世界的经济发展。
When I become as president, I will of course continue to assist the development of the semiconductor industry. There are many different areas in the semiconductor industry, from material to IC design to R&D to manufacturing, packaging, testing, etc. We will continue to put efforts in assisting these different industries and sectors so that we can build a comprehensive cluster and further develop the semiconductor industry. This, of course, will benefit the global economy as well.
继续第二题，我们改从比较前排一点，台视的秉仪。
先恭喜赖总统当选人，您好，我是台视新闻的记者萧秉仪，想跟您请教说，您刚刚有提到说要为国家团结合作，那么选前的一些攻防，选后呢要如何团结在野？那么会用怎么样的方式来跟在野来进行合作？那么有没有机会来跟在野的两个政党的这个党主席来碰面、来沟通、来聊？另外呢，有一些政策，您刚刚说福国利民的政策会纳入方针，那么哪一些对手的哪一些方针或政策是您未来有可能纳进来的？另外再提到说，这国民党还有民众党他们选前提出的联合政府，那么您当选之后有可能跟在野党进行联合内阁吗？谢谢。
好，要不要翻译
？Hello, I am Xiao Bingyi from TTV. I have three questions. First of all, you talked about uniting the society so that we can let go of the aggression during the election campaign. So I'm wondering whether or not you would find an opportunity to meet and communicate with the chairs of the two opposition parties. Secondly, you also talked about incorporating policies from the two other parties as long as they help benefit the well-being of the people. Can you tell us what are some of the policies that you might incorporate into your policies?And the third question is that during the election campaign, both TPP and the KMT talked about building a coalition government. Will you consider this when you're forming your cabinet?
好，谢谢秉仪刚刚宝贵的问题哈。第一个问题是放下在选举当中的争议啊，或者甚至是冲突。我们在今天晚上已经成功的走出了第一步。我在致辞当中有跟大家报告，我接到了柯文哲主席以及侯友宜市长恭贺的电话。我刚刚也在致辞当中肯定他们两位，我们这一次的选举共同完成了民主历史的新页，我们也跟国际社会传达台湾对民主体制的坚持。那第二点呢，我身为总统要领导国家，当然很乐意跟在野党的领袖大家一起见面，共商国事，来解决台湾面临的种种问题，彼此能够进一步的携手合作，推动国家进步。第三个是未来，我也会依据宪政的体制，筹组民主大联盟，用人为才，不分党派，希望让优秀的好人才能够加入政府的行列，为国家贡献力量。
Thank you, Bingyi, for your question. For your first question.About putting down the conflicts during the election campaign, I think we have successfully achieved the first step this evening. I mentioned during my address that I received calls of congratulations from both Chairperson Ke Wen-je and also Mayor Hou You-yi. During the phone call, I also recognized their contribution during this election.Because we together have written a new page for Taiwan's history of democracy, because we show to the international community that the Taiwanese people insist on a democratic way of life. As for the second question, as the president, of course, it is my responsibility to lead the country. So, naturally, I will find opportunities to meet with leaders of the opposition parties so that we can communicate and discuss the major issues for the country. We need to solve problems and also cooperate together to further advance the society. Number three, I mentioned earlier that under the constitutional framework and abiding by my belief in a democratic alliance, we will receive recommendations accept recommendations from various sectors, and we welcome any expert to assist us in building a better society.
Now let's go to the international press for the third question. And in the interest of time, if you could please keep your question short. Now, since I had mentioned Reuters accidentally in the last one, I'd like to invite Imo from Reuters to ask the next question.
我是路透社记者李博，恭喜。
不谢。
Mr. Lai, you have made it very loud and clear that you will follow President Tsai's stable and cautious cross-strait policy and that you will not change the status quo. But during the past years, 8 years, we have also seen that President Tsai has repeatedly offered dialogues and goodwill with Beijing, but those efforts were rejected. So we'd like to know, how exactly would you do differently from President Tsai to demonstrate your goodwill? And what exactly will you do to re-engage and restart dialogue with Beijing? And if, unfortunately, those efforts were rejected by China again, do you have a plan B? 谢谢。
谢谢。
首先，我是来自路透社的 email， 非常恭喜赖总统当选人。那么，您在过去这段时间不断的强调，您会维持这个蔡总统过去这一段时间的两岸政策，继续维持一个稳定的这个不躁进的两岸政策，而且也不改变现状。但是我们在过去这八年也看到，虽然蔡总统在很多不同的场合都展现了这个善意，并且也愿意和北京当局对话，但是呢，都遭到北京当局的拒绝。所以我想要请教您，您相较于蔡总统过去的做法，您会有什么样子不同的做法来展现出您的善意呢？要具体而言，怎么样子才能够重启和北京当局的对话呢？那如果又再次被拒绝的话，您有没有另外的这个计划呢？
好，谢谢你哈。过去八年来，蔡英文总统在外交、国防两岸的稳健领导是深受国际社会的肯定。未来我也将依据中华民国宪政体制推动两岸的事务，希望未来两岸都能够回到健康有序的交流。当然也一如你所说，蔡英文总统这八年来持续不断的释出善意，但很可惜，中国并没有给予应有的回应啊。那我们也希望在未来新的情势之下，中国也能够体认到和平是符合双方的利益，台海的稳定更是世界安全跟繁荣的必要元素啊。那中国也能够体认到，他也有责任，大家共同来促进两岸的稳定跟发展。
Thank you for your question. In the past 8 years, President Tsai had a very steady foreign policy and national defense policy. Her way of doing things have received recognition from the international community. So, therefore,according to the constitutional order of the Republic of China, I will conduct cross-strait affairs according to that system so that cross-strait relations can return to a healthy and sustainable way of exchanges. Of course, as you said, President Tsai has been extending goodwill many times in the past 8 years. However, China did not provide the response that should have been there.So in the future, we hope that China will recognize the new situation and understand that only peace benefits both sides of the strait. In addition, the global peace and stability depends upon the peace and stability of the Taiwan Strait. Therefore, we hope that China will understand the situation because China also has a responsibility.
Okay.
是的，继续我们第三题。 邀请媒体们，中央社的素萍。
主席，你刚刚说，对不起，我是中央社的记者叶素萍。刚刚你说有希望跟其他党团结合作，不过因为现在目前看起来就是国会是三党不过半，那你首相要面对的是2月1号的新民意，那接下来我们是不是会争取立法院的正副龙头？那我们跟在野党有合作的空间吗？因为之前选前蓝白有说他们要合作，那韩国瑜可能会当立法院长，那对于这一点你怎么看？然后另外距离520接棒其实还有4个月的时间，这段时间你有没有哪些要优先推动的项目？然后最后来一个比较轻松的，就是你可以谈一下你们的那个胜选的心路历程，然后你们等一下有没有想要优先做什么？谢谢。
好，谢谢。我刚刚在致辞的时候已经有跟大家报告，就这次台湾人民决定要有一个有能力的政府，以及一个有效率监督的国会。我身为总统领导国家，必须要尊重这样的民意。所以未来不仅仅我会打造开放政府、公开透明以外，也会跟在野党进行沟通、交流、参与、合作，来解决台湾所面临的各项重大问题。那第二个是，我现在还是副总统，在520之前我还是副总统的身份，所以我还有副总统的工作必须要尽职的完成。那当然我也是总统当选人，在未来几个月里面最重要的工作应该是寻找人才，然后组成好的政府来服务台湾人民。
So the question was from Ms. Ye from CNA, and the question was in 3 parts. First of all, you talked about working with the opposition parties. However, it seems now that neither party, or none of the 3 parties, will command a majority in the legislative yuan. But these legislators will soon assume their offices on the 1st of February, and we have heard from both the blue and white camps that they will probably try and nominate Mr. Han Kuo-yu to be the speaker of the legislative yuan, and what are your views? The second question had to do with the inauguration is on May the 20th, so there's still 4 months to go. So what are some of the what kind of policies would you prioritize until you are inaugurated? And the third question was about your thoughts for these past few months. And President-elect Lai answered, number one,the most important thing for Taiwan, the clearest message from the Taiwanese people during this election cycle is that they want a competent government, but also a very strong check and balance. So as the president, of course, we need to respect, it is our responsibility to respect the opinions of the Taiwanese people. Therefore, we will form an open and transparent government, and I will continue to communicate, exchange ideas,and involve the opposition parties and cooperate with them to solve the major issues. For the second question, of course, I'm only going to be inaugurated on the 20th of May, but now I'm still the vice president, so there are jobs to do. And of course, I will fulfill those obligations. But also as the president-elect, I think my priority would be finding the talents that would help me form the best government to serve the Taiwanese people.
由于时间的关系，我们的国际胜选记者会到这里结束提问。我们要邀请未来的总统和副总统能够跟媒体们挥挥手，让大家留下这个历史经典一刻的照片。这是台湾民选史上第一次政党的3连胜。稍会我们的未来的总统跟副总统也即将会跟率领所有的竞选团队到舞台发表胜选的感言。现在由他们向大家来挥挥手，留下这个历史经典一刻。
Because of time constraints, our press conference has now concluded. This is the first time in Taiwan's history a political party has received 3 terms in office. Following this event, our next president and vice president, Lai Ching-de and Xiao Meiqing, will lead members of the campaign to deliver their victory marks to the nation. Thank you all for participating in this press conference.
再次谢谢大家来参与我们的国际记者会，谢谢，我们的记者会到这里圆满的结束，再度的对大家表达辛苦与感谢。